can actually find using values.
Yeah. Okay, I love you guys.
Yeah, just move to any.
Schools, I found that Nagoya University offered this English language program where I can study agriculture, and I heard Nagoya University also has a good agriculture science program, which is what I wanted to apply for in the beginning anyway. So I got lucky, I guess.
So I really wanted to study in Japan because is not far from my home country, and it has really good reputation for sciences and technology. And the reason why I chose Nagoya University is because it's one of the very few universities in Japan that offers good international programs.
One of my main goals in college was to expand my experiences in ways that I could never have done if I had stayed in Singapore. And Nagoya University is incredibly well recognized and well-developed international program. It seemed like the perfect place for me to experience that kind of university life. The opportunity to make friends with people from all around the world while studying in one of Japan's most prestigious national universities. But no one could really say no to that.
I wanted a change of scenery, and Japan seemed normal enough, but I also really like the curriculum here at Nagoya University because it includes a lot of research opportunities for undergraduates, which is relatively rare in other countries.
Yeah. So in the first year, you would take introductory courses, which the class size is about 30 people. I think that's the reasonable number. When you come to the second year beyond, you're going to take specialized courses, which the class size is about 10 people, give or take. I think that small size class is really great because you will have a lot of opportunities to interact with professors, teaching assistants, as well as your classmates.
Yes, I'm currently researching in laboratory of biochemistry in the biology program in Nagoya University. I'm currently researching on Arabidopsis pollen, and to be specific, I research on the genes and proteins that contribute to these pollen's formation. And I'm currently doing a lot of polymerase chain reaction, or PCR in short, and also transformation.
It's pretty good. It's a good environment for studying, and there's the best of both worlds here in Nagoya. It's a really big city, and there's a lot of like central places you can go for shopping or just hanging out, and there's a lot of beautiful nature and scenery around Nagoya in the prefecture of Aichi, so it's a pretty nice balance.
My first year student's life was really amazing. The biggest support that I think from G30 program is the housing. So when I first came to Japan, I got the chance to live in the dorm of Nagoya University. And the dorm is a really nice place to live. The room is really, it's virtually furnished with everything. And and your friends in the same cohort live in the same, in the same buildings. So yeah, it's really easy to interact with different people, make new friends in the first year, and come to their rooms, ask for help with the homeworks and other things. So it's really great.
Most people can definitely survive in Japan with just rudimentary Japanese. I believe that the key to experiencing Japan on a deeper and much more intimate level comes from being able to speak the language to some extent. The times when I talk to my Japanese friends at club activities, or to my colleagues at part-time job, and to the oji-san that cuts my hair and so on, these are experiences that I do not think I would have enjoyed as greatly had I not been able to speak the language. Now that said, of course, you don't have to speak it perfectly. As long as you show effort, in trying to converse in their language. Most Japanese people here are helpful enough to try and help you get your point across.
So yes, so there was this incident where in my part-time job place, I wanted to go there and get my salary. So it was my first salary in that place. So I went there, but it was already past the salary date, right? So when I come into the shop, I have to tell the manager, can I have my salary? So salary in Japanese is kyuryo. So I should have said like, kyuryo moratte mo ii desu ka? But then instead I said kyuri, which means cucumber. And then that day the whole shop heard me talking like that to the manager, and then they were laughing at me. So yeah, that was really embarrassing.
I think I want to go to grad school first, and after that I'll decide whether I want to pursue the academia or industrial route. But in any case, I'm very glad I chose Meidai, because come grad school applications, there's not a lot of undergrads who already have a solid foundation of research experience that we get to obtain here. So yeah, I have high hopes for grad school, but let's see.
So there are a lot of scholarship opportunities at Nagoya University. So when you enter the first year, if you don't receive any entrance scholarships, the schools will continuously send you information about scholarships, and sometimes they will even recommend you for scholarship organization if they think that you are a strong candidate. For example, I didn't receive any entrance scholarships, but in the last few years, I've received like three different scholarships from private organizations, and the amount is really good. So I don't do any part-time jobs. And besides, the school also offers tuition exemptions, so you can apply in March annually. So thank you guys so much for considering Nagoya University for your undergraduate study. I guarantee that you will definitely find your home and your community here, and we will be very happy to have you join us.